Hi guys, November 23rd, 2020. We're losing one of our rescue arowana, civil arowana, named Freddy. We got him about in 2012, I want to say. Yeah, I'm pretty sure 2012, so we've had him about 8 years. And he was already about 2 feet back then, so I'm guessing he's about 10 years old. I'm not sure what happened. He seems to have developed some problem with digestion and keeping himself upright. I mean, he's still breathing, but it's the agony. He's not gonna make it. So that's the end of our Freddy. He's about 40 inches. Tip to tip, you can see the yardstick. It's about a couple inches on each side. You can add safely. Our vulture catfish are opportunistic, so they removed his part of his mouth right here, or lower jaw. But other than that, other than little bloatiness, I'd say I don't see any other. And he wasn't swimming for the past 2 months. He wasn't swimming right. He was keeping his head down low, and his back would be facing, his hind half would be facing up, and the head would be facing down low. All right. Sorry, buddy. That's our sad news of the day. I think he's a male because of how short are the extensions, the pelvic extensions. The extensions on the pelvic fin, it seems to me the females have their extensions go way past the anus. This is the anus. And the females' extensions go past it. All the males we had shorter extensions. And also our females are a lot darker on the back. Right here, it's usually a lot darker. And so being the pale one, being pale and the pelvic extensions and the fact that he was fighting with other males, especially with the alpha male, when we had a female to mate with, makes me think, of course, Freddy was a male. And that's the end of the journey for him. If you want to see the bony tongue, this is why they call the bony tongue. The tongue is bony, and it's very strong, and it's used to mash and destroy whatever it catches in its mouth before it swallows it. Thanks for watching, guys.